As a video editor, are you frustrated when clients give you images of people to add to your landscape videos and those images are in portrait mode? I'll show you how to change this to this. And when you do receive a portrait image, the big temptation is just to add it to the video by cropping it to fit in the 16:9 video image. But there's two problems to this. First, you lose some of the image, which doesn't always work if you've got to hide a face or something. And even if you're able to retain the important part of the image, it'll lose resolution because you've reduced the pixel count by cropping into so much. I previously published a video about the grown-up AI application, Prome AI. On that video, I concentrated on the generation of images from text. The video link is in the description below. But there's more to Prome AI because the application can answer all of your dreams. I'm going to concentrate on just one of the tools in the Prome AI arsenal. It's called Outpainting, and the name says it all. I've got this image of a fountain in a lake in North Carolina. The image is good, but I want to add it to a 16:9 video. So let's use it in this wedding video reception where the speaker's talking about the lake where the groom proposed to the bride. And this is the image that I was given to insert into the video. I'll set it in as a B-roll, but now what do I do to cover the speaker in the background? Perhaps drag the corners to fill the screen. But look how pixelated the image is. Now I'll drag an already outpainted image from Prome AI into the timeline. And what a difference. So let me show you how I did it in the Prome AI application. Here's the image I'm going to use. Select Outpainting from the left-hand sidebar. Drag the image into the image well at the top left of the sidebar. I'll change the size of the output to landscape 16:9. You can resize to fill the screen if you want to. Then press generate. Now for this one, I've left it in real time so that you can see how long it took. I find that images that output vegetation and the scenery give the best results. You'll find that images that outpaint people, particularly faces, are sometimes not as realistic. As you see in this outpainting of this lake in the grass. And when it's finished, look at the generation of the sunlight through the trees in one of the images, just brilliant. You can preview the image in low res, as well as buy coins to download the full resolution HD image, or you can upscale the images to 4K. And if your original image is not HD quality, you'll be warned that it's not good enough for the upscaling, but it will let you do it and then go through the process of resizing the image for you. The downside to this is that you'll need to pay more coins to do that. I'll cancel in the meantime because that's another lesson. I'll go back to the outpainting and try the scene with people and see what results that gives. Notice that the person on the left is only partly in the image. Part of the shoulder is missing and also the eye on her face. So it's going to be interesting to see what the software will do to generate that missing right-hand side of that person. Drag it into the image well. Check the size if you want, though it remembers the last size you chose. Then press generate. I've speeded it up this time. I'll select the kitchen that's done well with the cabinets, but it's a little unrealistic to what it's done with the eye and the shoulder that it's generated. So let's try this flower image. I'll generate and also speed it up. I'll check the right-hand image. And that one is realistic. The car would be hard to pick as not real. Now I'll check this wedding scene with the bride and groom fully in view. I've sped up the process so you don't have to sit through it again. I'll check the middle scene with the generated person on the left. That face is unrealistic. Now the scene on the left. That face is better. And now the scene without any generated faces. Perfect. So what do you think about our painting? As I said, it can be brilliant, but you do need to pick your scenes. Of course, you could pick a scene with a face that's unrealistic and use the built-in erase and replace feature that's part of Probe AI, and that will remove the person with that unrealistic face. But then again, that's for another tutorial. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Thanks for watching.